Hello everybody and welcome on my YouTube channel. You are with Alan Dries and today we will test a new hero. We are on the test server and this hero will be probably the Christmas hero. I'm still not sure. It will be Mousquetaire. I want first of all to attract your attention about a statistic because it's really interesting. So it's a backliner, okay, she's woman and mechanic, interesting to know. But after, it's really, really interesting. We have 39k HP, okay, it's not that much, but she's a backliner. We have 660 armor, so it's a pretty nice, a low magical resistance, 310, so okay, another time she's in backline, so she's not so exposed for magical damage. She has interesting score of dodge, 50, so it's interesting if, for example, she's totally in the backline and ninja is jumping on her, it's an example. She has a crazy attack power, 8100. And crazy critical score, 2100, and also a good score of penetration, 210. And with the training field, you are able to increase her HP, her attack damage even more, and her physical critic even more. So, by her statistics, she looks like really, really aggressive. We will see, in fact, and let's begin to check her skills. Mousquetaire has 4 skills, the ultimate one, laser cannon. Lisa summons a laser cannon to damage and lock enemies. So, we don't know actually damage that it will be, but we can guess that it will control the enemy in the same time, so it can be grit. Second skill, the green one, height energy shell. Lisa fires off a height energy shell, damaging and knocking back an enemy. So damage look like pretty correct and it's another control, so it's really good. Landmines, Lisa set up multiple landmines that damage and stun nearby enemies when triggered. We have to see how much damage it will be, but it will stun in the same time, so it's another control. And finally, the purple skill, Heavy Weapon Recharge. Lisa increase her own agility by nearly 400. Okay, it's a DPS, no problem. Let's now discover her position in the battlefield. Mousquetaire is a backliner hero, so we will compare with other backliners. So what we have, she's behind Sorceress, it's a good point. Other hero of in front of Inferno, it's not so good, but okay. She's behind Manipulator, perfect, and in front of other, it's also interesting. She's behind Witch, it's not so good, but she's in front of Lightbringer, it's really nice. After... she's behind Chaplain, okay. Behind Chaplain, okay, in front of them, it's normal. And finally... Okay, she's behind Windranger. Interesting to guess. Okay, so her position is more or less classical, if we can tell, except that she's behind Witch. It's not so comfortable, but she has some dodge, so she can hold a little in the backline. We will see in 1v1 how her skills are going on. Round 1, fight! I'm really interesting to watch how her skills are working. So, this is the first one. Okay, it's a knockback. This is landmine. So, it's totally random, but it's stunning and dealing nice damage. It was not critical hit, so it's interesting. Her energy looks like to grown up really fast. Because 30 seconds, she's nearly full. Okay, the knockback another time. Landmines are really random. And now, it's the ultimate. Okay. Oh, in fact, they can cast during the ultimate, but they absolutely can't move. So it's really nice too. Landmines are crazy. She's nearly able to kill them. And we'll see, perhaps, yes, she will do a second ultimate, I think. Oh, it's a really interesting. Ultimate doesn't deal so much damage, but it's lock the enemy and it's touch a full screen. Statistic, ooh, 240,000 damage in just with just two heroes in front of her. Another time, I have a good expectation about her, and we will see in fight how it will be. Against a full healing team, we will compare with another damage dealer who has been probably nerfed on the live server, but who is pretty good on the test server, so it's a mechanical destroyer. And we can see her skill in action. Even against a team with a lot of interruption, a lot of time saved, and some absorption of damage with a cleric, we will see the result. Like I told, this team in front of me is saving a lot of time. But it's not a problem. It will be enough for what I want to show. So ultimate skill is just controlling the movement. It's not canceled every skill or every attack. Enemy can attack, he can launch the skill, but he can't move. And landmines are totally random, so sometimes it's really good, sometimes not. But for heroes who are moving on the battlefield, it will be really interesting. And you see, two landmines, I stun 100% of the enemy team. And we'll see the result. $328k damage. You can see that Mechanical Destroyer on test server is also really nice, but on the live server, it's another problem. So, I want to see against a real team what we can do with this Musketeer. Against a standard Turtle Fighter team, we will see the result. First thing that I can tell, the landmines are really disabled by the rolling or turtle fighter, because all the mines that you put on the battlefield, every time that the turtle fighter will roll, she will remove all without taking any damage. So turtle fighter is a good counter, like you can see right now, for this hero. But it doesn't matter, she's able to deal really nice damage. Ultimate. An ultimate effect is pretty long. Taro is full life, so we'll see. Oh! He gets totally nuked. And finally, we have a really nice damage for Mechanical Destroyer and Musketeer, nearly 300,000 damage. So, even when you have Turtle Fighter in front of her, she's able to deal really, really nice damage. Let's see against a non-Turtle Fighter team. Again, this non-Turtle Fighter team really aggressive. I specially didn't use a Turtle Fighter to compare. I use a defensive setup to be able to absorb enough damage before to deal a lot of damage with Musketeer. So we are seeing now what's happened. Okay, and the ultimate of Musketeer will do the job, I think. Voilà. 47 seconds. So, 250k damage in 45 seconds, less than 45 seconds. Phew, she is really nice. And don't forget that all her skills, first ultimate, second and third, are controlling the enemy, so it's an additional value for this hero. Let's speak about his strengths and weaknesses. 4 good points for this hero. First point, it's her looking. She's definitely cool in my opinion, and even her pictures is interesting. Second point, she has a correct survivability. We saw her statistic at the beginning. Correct pool of HP, especially with training, good armor for backliner, no magical resistance, but actually in backline it doesn't really matter, and even a good dodge score, so she's totally correct. Third point, her control. We saw her skills, and skill 1, skill 2, and skill 3 are controlling the enemy, so it's really nice because it's an additional value for 1 DPS. And last point, for sure, her damages. You saw that in some time, she's able to deal really crazy damage. Let's now discover her weaknesses. 3 little points in my opinion that we can consider as weaknesses. First point, it's the more bad in my opinion, it's the time animation of the ultimate. She cast the cannon, go up, cast during 1, 2, perhaps 3 seconds and begin to deal the effect. So it's pretty long for one skill, and sometimes she's dying before that the cannon come in action, and the cannon is disabled also. Second point, in some situation her position is not so good, but it's a little minus. And last point, it's a random side of her third skill, because landmines are totally random, so sometimes she will launch 3 mines in the other side and it will be amazing, all the enemy team will be controlled and damaged, and some other time she will throw 3 mines in our side, and finally she will do nothing with this skill. But the little good point, if you have some hero who are changing their position, chemist, ninja, sapper or something like that, she can be able to control them with the mine that you have in your side. So let's discover my final advice about this hero. I just received the confirmation that this hero will be released during a Christmas event this year, so it's exactly what I was thinking. This hero is nice, definitely. I don't know exactly the conditions that we will have to obtain her, but she seems to be worth it to invest without any problem. High damage, high control, correct survivability. For little minus, it's definitely a good hero to add in your arsenal. Thanks everybody for watching this review. I hope that you enjoyed it. From my side, I really enjoy this hero. And if you have some feedback, don't hesitate to write it in comment. I will follow it from the right person, and we can have some modification of this hero, even if for this hero specially we don't need so much modification. If you don't want to miss nothing about my actuality, you can follow my Facebook page, my Twitter, also subscribe to my YouTube channel, and if you want to support my work, you can click on the last link on your screen. Bye bye!